Good morning. You're watching Proactive London. Mark Dickinson, Chief Executive at Inspired PLC, joins us this morning. Good morning, Mark. How are you?
Good morning, Chris. Very well, thank you.
Glad to hear it, and thank you very much for your time. The energy crisis has never been higher on businesses' agendas than right now, which I know you highlighted on your Radio 4 Today programme interview yesterday. Can I ask you, firstly, what type of businesses do you work with, and what are their main concerns at this present time?
Yeah, so we're an energy and sustainability advisor, really working with businesses from some of the largest in the country. So your major retailers, your major manufacturers, all the way down to maybe care homes, boutique hotels, restaurants. Really, anybody who's spending over £100,000 a year in energy is somebody who would benefit from working in the way that we work.
Yeah, you mentioned the £100,000 figure. Having heard various interviews recently in the media, I know a lot of commercial businesses and pubs are seeing their energy prices rocket beyond all recognition. So, of course, we understand some customers are also finding it hard to find a supplier. Are you witnessing this in your arena?
Yeah, so I mean, I think one of the challenges at the moment is there's typical pinch points in the industry where many people have their contracts expiring around about October. So that creates a natural kind of bottleneck. But actually, what's really driving things at the moment is just the incredibly high prices we're seeing and the volatility in those prices. So actually, it's very difficult for energy suppliers to make proposals for customers. Sometimes they're arriving with us and they're being withdrawn within 1 hour of us receiving them. Now, that's not particularly the energy supplier's fault. That's the market we're operating in. I think the other challenge for energy suppliers is that currently, with the high prices, they require credit insurance for all the customers they serve. And that's really becoming very hard to get as well. So that's causing a number of customers to have to provide kind of bonds or prepayments to be able to get a supply at all. So it's probably the most challenging times I've seen over the 25 years of my career.
It sounds like a real domino effect in action there. So with energy prices at what we can safely say is an unprecedented high, how can Inspired help customers at the moment? What are you doing to inform customers and come to their aid?
Yeah, so I think kind of there's two parts to it. You've got customers who are coming out of their energy contracts, supply contracts now in this October period. And for them, it's very much about making sure they've got a short-term supply, making sure that they're focused on optimizing when in the day they're utilizing their energy. So making sure they minimize the cost as far as they can, and also making sure they look at their energy accounting properly. So there's often mistakes in supplier invoices, and clearly people have been paying, say, 10, 11p a kilowatt. They're coming out to now pay 60p a kilowatt. And you don't want to pay for one more of those units than you absolutely have to. So having a good energy accounting service to make sure that you're not paying for units you shouldn't be becomes really important. And then really optimizing how you use your energy during the period to minimize cost. And then finally reducing that energy consumption in the medium to long term, which is really where you're going to avoid the real pain of the crisis.
I imagine some businesses, I mean, dependent on the size of the business, I mentioned pubs because that was the detail I was listening to on the radio the other day, maybe you have not even thought about having somebody like Inspired on their side. What would your top tips for businesses be who are currently trying to navigate a new energy supply?
Yeah, so the most important thing at the moment is if you're big enough as a customer and you're able to get a flexible contract, take that. That flexible contract, the way to think about it is like a maybe tracker mortgage, so it's going to be linked to the market. But when we're at all times high, it's going to have the opportunity of coming down in the shortest order when the commodity markets revert to their normal behavior. If you're not a big enough customer to be able to get a flexible contract, the next thing to do is take a contract for as short a time as possible. So if you have somebody calling you, offering you any advice, saying do a 2-3 year contract at these prices, that shouldn't be done. If you can do 1 to 6 months, take a 6 month contract, certainly don't take more than a year. I think the other thing in that contract is to really try to make sure that you get a contract with what we'd call a multiple rate. So a different rate for different times of the day. So then you've got some levers you can pull in terms of moving your consumption away from the expensive times of the day into the cheaper times of the day and reducing your energy cost overall. Those would be the immediate things people can do. And the very next thing is really start thinking about, okay, over the next 12 months, what actions can I take? What change can I make? What investments can I make to actually reduce my energy consumption in that medium term?
This energy crisis really is at the forefront of everybody's mind, down to, you know, households as well. Who would have thought it was going to come down to exactly how you manage throughout the day to gauge the energy you're using? We always used to take it very much for granted. Now, the new Prime Minister has had a heck of a first week in the job, but Liz Truss is expected to make an announcement, a mini budget, if you will, next week. What do we need to see in that that can really make a difference? What does the government really have to put on the table now?
Yeah, so we've obviously got the, if you like, the energy support scheme coming in for businesses. I think kind of the detail of that's going to be really important. And also for these customers who are coming out of contracts, certainly they shouldn't be taking any action until they know the results of this scheme. And we're going to be helping customers understand and make sure they can comply with that correctly. I think the detailed scheme becomes really important. So as much certainty as they can give, so there's no ambiguity. Things like they're talking about having a 3-month review, which I kind of understand, but ultimately that's going to cause further uncertainty for customers. So actually, the longer the period of certainty we have in terms of the scheme, and then understanding, you know, who the vulnerable industries are going forward, who might get longer term support, that also becomes really important. So I think the scheme itself is going to help protect businesses from, really being kind of impacted and ceasing to become going concerns from the energy crisis. But we really need to understand the detail of it. And then the role for Inspired in that is really to make sure we work with the customers, keep them informed, make sure that we make sure everyone who qualifies for the scheme takes advantage for it. And if there are rules that allow the compliance to be maintained, then ultimately we're helping to make sure that customers don't break any of those rules and cause themselves any problems. So that's really the focus of the period. I think the scheme gets announced hopefully next week. And once we all understand that, businesses will be able to start to deal with the immediate crisis and then start planning for how they reduce energy consumption in the future so we don't get to the situation again.
Well, as you say, a lot of it is dependent on the government's announcement next week. It's a big jigsaw puzzle and all the pieces are currently still up in the air. All we can do is keep tabs on it and listen to people such as yourself for information in the subject area you know best. In the meantime, Mark Dickinson, Chief Executive at Inspired PLC. Thank you very much for your time today at Proactive London.
Thank you.